Welcome to the complete Dark Matter guide for Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. We are going through everything you need to know since I already unlocked it. While going for Dark Matter, I encountered many things that if I knew earlier, could have completed it faster. So hereby, I share my knowledge so you can unlock Dark Matter fast and efficient. There will be timestamps in the timeline and also in the description below, so you can skip ahead to whatever you're here for, and also makes it much easier if you come back to the video every time that you want to refresh yourself. Everything what we will go through in this video is shown on screen now, and I've tried to make it as easy as it can be so you can guide yourself throughout the video. Also in the description below will be other videos where I go more in depth about all of the hardest challenges, like for example the long shots for the M79, so then you know what I'm referring to throughout this video. Be aware that at the time of making this video, Black Ops Cold War just has been released 2 months ago. So if you're watching this 6 months later from now, for example, that a lot probably has changed. So keep that in mind. But if you're watching this now 6 months later, then make sure to check the description below, because then I probably made a new improved guide. You will need to complete 35 camo challenges in order to unlock gold on a specific weapon. Once you get gold for every weapon in a specific weapon category, like for example the LMGs, then you will be awarded with the diamond camo. There are a total of 9 different weapon categories, of which the knife and the special belong together. So a total of 9 diamond camos. Once you unlock these 9 diamond camos, you will be awarded with the Dark Matter camo. Normally, in the previous Call of Duties, like for example Modern Warfare, you needed to unlock gold for every weapon except the DLC weapons to be awarded with the Damascus camo, aka the Dark Matter camo in Cold War. They changed that in Black Ops Cold War, since this time it doesn't mind which weapon you get gold for in order to be awarded with the diamond camo. For example, to get the diamond camo for the submachine guns, you will need to unlock the gold camo for 5 SMGs. And as you see, there are a total of 6 SMGs. You can choose which 5 you do eventually to get the diamond camo and be one step closer to Dark Matter. I did this myself too, since I unlocked diamond with the DLC weapon MAC-10 instead of the AK-47U. Each camo can only be done when you are a certain level, which differs per weapon category, what is shown on screen now. The fastest way to complete the camos is when all of your weapons are leveled up, because then you only can do the camo challenges. There are 3 ways to level up your weapons fast in Cold War. The first one is in zombies, since you will get a lot of XP out of there, but I still do not recommend that, since you won't make any progress within the camo challenges as you are playing zombies. This is only meant for people that hate multiplayer and just want to level up the weapons fast and then go back to multiplayer to grind for the camo challenges. The next one I really do recommend, and I did it also myself, is in Dirty Bomb. It doesn't mind if you kill people that are already down, since it will register as a kill and you will gain 3 times as much XP per kill than normally in multiplayer. I've tested out myself and made a video about it where I'll go more in depth what's in the description below. And the last one is in hardcore mode, but then on a small map like Nuketown. Every time you kill someone, you get a medal. The more people you kill, the more medals you get. Every medal varies from 50 till 500 XP. I've noticed when I play in the hardcore mode, I get a lot of more medals than normal. And so in the end game, more XP for my levels and also for the weapons. But always remember, when leveling your weapons, that you will go through the camo challenges. For example, there's a camo challenge where you need to get 100 headshots for the assault weapons. Aim a little bit higher than normal while leveling the weapons. So in summary, fully level up your weapons so that the last camo slot opens while going through some of the camo challenges. But your main focus is on the leveling progress. The hardest weapons to complete gold with are the launchers and the M79, so make sure while grinding for Dark Matter that you always have one of these 3 weapons as your secondary. Because these are the most time consuming, since you depend on score streak and equipments where there are not of many of them in each game, and if they are, they will be destroyed by another teammate. This will save you a lot of stress and will ultimately ensure that you most likely only have to complete the kill challenges for these weapons at the end. Now for the maps, there's only one map that's meant for the grind of Dark Matter, and that's of course Nuketown. If it's available, then play Nuketown. It's a fast-paced game mode, very chaotic and always enemies everywhere, so perfect for almost all of the camo challenges. Other maps that are great too is Crossroads, Satellite, Raid and Moscow. I made another video in which you see multiple class setups for each weapon specific to certain camo challenges. Since there were a lot of weapons and loadouts, I made a separate video where you can go through all of the best loadouts for every weapon. So keep in mind, I will refer to this more often throughout this video. In order to complete the spray camo, you will have to get a specific amount of kills, and this will unlock eventually while leveling up your weapons, since you don't need a lot of kills. The spray camo is the easiest to complete, so I recommend recommend that you don't focus on this at all, as you will likely complete it when you go through the more difficult camo challenges. And this also applies to the next camo, Stripes, where you will need to make a certain amount of headshots. This is also a pretty simple one, you don't need a lot of them, and like I said before, you will most likely complete it when going for the more difficult camo challenges. So I do recommend to ignore the spray and the Stripes camo until you're done with all of the other camo challenges. Just remember while leveling up your weapons that you always aim a little bit higher than normal for the headshots. To complete Classic, you must get the 5 kill streak, aka Bloodthirsties, 20 times in total, and these stack up. So if you get 5 kills, this counts for 1, if you get 10 kills, this counts for 2, 15 kills for 3, and so on. You do not want to get killed while you're on a kill streak, so make sure you use a suppressor, the perks Ninja and Ghost, and the field mic, because this way you ensure that the enemy will not see you on the minimap because of the suppressor and the perk Ghost, or they won't hear you because of the perk Ninja, and because you use a suppressor, they also won't hear you. The field mic comes in very handy since you will most likely camp most of the time while you're on a kill streak of 4, for example, and you only need one more, then you can deploy your field mic and see the enemies around you to eventually get the 5th kill. The best game modes for the Bloodthirsties are Dominant or Hardpoint, since then you always know where the enemy will be because they will probably be on one of the objectives. Also, Nuketown is very good for the Bloodthirsties for the secondaries. The next camo, Geometric, can be pretty hard since you need a certain amount of long shots for most of the weapons. In overall, the best way to complete the long shots is in the Hardcore mode. For most of the weapons that have low damage, it's better to play in the Hardcore mode because then you only need 1 or 2 bullets for a long shot instead of 5 or 6 bullets in the normal Core mode. I do recommend Hardcore for the shotguns, pistols and the submachine guns, as it's more difficult to get long shots with these weapons. It's less harder with the assault weapons, snipers, LMGs and the tactical rifles, since these come pretty naturally. Just make sure you use the right attachments for it, so you can have high damage at range, a scope to look further away, and make sure to use anything to hold your stability, so you have less recoil. Like I said before, check the top link in the description where I show different class setups for each weapon and also the best for the long shots. In overall, the best map for long shots is Satellite or Nuketown. The map Satellite is good because it's mainly large and open, so 9 out of 10 times you get a long shot. And Nuketown is good for the long shots at certain spots, which you can see now in the background. When you get a kill on one of these spots, it counts as a long shot. Nuketown is in overall the best map for long shots for the pistols, SMGs and the shotguns. Satellite or Armada are the best maps for the snipers, tactical rifles, LMGs and the assault weapons. In order to complete Flora, you will have to get a certain amount of kills against enemies that are detected, stunned or blind by your score streaks, equipment or field upgrade. Except for the snipers, for which you will have to do something else, but I will come to that after this one. But in overall, very easy to do, just make sure you get kills while your UV is in the sky, or that when you stun somebody, you take him out instantly, or that you kill someone that's in the circle of your field mic. All these kills will count towards this camo challenge. As score streaks, use the UUV and the counter UV. Make sure when you deploy one of these score streaks that you're near the enemy to take them out. Do not use the UV, for example, in your spawn, because that's a waste of your UV since it's only there for a short time. Use a stun or a flash grenade to stun or blind the enemy, but remember, when you throw a stun grenade, for example, you will have to be really quick to kill someone, since I've noticed you got only a few seconds for it. As field upgrade, use the field mic and deploy it somewhere in a high traffic area. For example, in Nuketown, deploy it somewhere in the middle around the 2 bosses. Every time when you see this, when you kill an enemy, then you know you're on the right track and making progress with this camo. Now for the snipers, you need to get 50 kills while holding your breath. Very easy to do. While aiming down sight, press the button that's meant to hold your breath. It's the left analog stick on the PS4, and I also think that's the same for the Xbox. I don't know for sure, but I think it's shift on the PC. Play bigger maps like Satellite or Armada, and then just aim at high traffic areas while holding your breath. Every kill while holding your breath will count towards this camo. There are 2 ways to complete Science. One is where you need to kill 50 enemies taking cover from you, and this one can be pretty annoying. But I got a lot of this done, and yes, I'm gonna say it again, on the map Nuketown. Just kill everybody that's on the other side of the map in the window, and this will count towards this camo challenge. If you have trouble with this one, just make sure you take out someone that he is behind something. A little bit off or something like that doesn't count. The enemy really has to be behind something from you. So every enemy that is head glitching is perfect for this camo to take out. And again, about this one, I made a video. You can check the description below where I'll go more in depth about this one and I show all the best spots on almost every map. The other way to complete Science is to get 75 point blank kills, and this only applies to the submachine guns and the shotguns. This one can be pretty annoying, since you really gotta stick your barrel in the ass of the enemy to get a point blank kill. The barrel has to touch the enemy, and when you see this, you know you have taken a point blank kill. Best way to complete this one is in the normal core mode, and then just a fast paced small map like Nuketown. Use a stun or a flash grenade to blind the enemy. Once they're blind, rush them to get a point blank kill. Now we're at the last camo, and that's the psychedelic camo, where you need to make 25 double kills. Just play objective game modes like Hardpoint or Domination on small maps like Nuketown. Then just rush the enemies to get the double kills, but make sure not to reload once you get one kill, since most likely there will be one more enemy nearby. For the snipers, I do recommend to play on the map Armada or Satellite, since it's a little bit harder to get the double kills with these. Use the right attachments that give you more aim down sight, so you can make another kill faster right after your first kill to get the double kill. Now we're gonna look into the launchers, M79 and the knife. Like I said before, your main goal is to fully level up your weapon until the last camo slot opens, so you can prioritize on the hardest camo challenges. But of course, while leveling your weapons, you can still do some of the camo challenges. For all the kills for the launchers and the M79, I do recommend objective game modes in the hardcore mode, and for the knife just in the normal core mode. This will come eventually while leveling up your weapons or going for the more difficult camo challenges, so do not focus on this one. To complete the camo stripes for the launchers, you will need to destroy 50 equipments, score streaks or vehicles, 50 for the Sigma and 25 for the RPG. This because the Sigma has a lock-on capability and the RPG doesn't. But still very easy to do and will come eventually. To complete the camo stripes for the knife, you will have to get 25 backstabber kills. These are just kills from behind. Play on a small map like Nuketown while using a stun or a flash grenade. And try to sneak up behind the enemy while stunning them with your stun grenade to get a kill from behind. Oh my god, now for the next one, the long shots. To complete stripes for the M79, you will have to get 50 long shots. I really hated this one most of them all, since the enemy has to be really far away and I didn't know where to shoot exactly. But I ended up going in a private match with a friend of mine to test where to shoot in almost every map to see when it's a long shot. And when I got back on multiplayer, I got most of the long shots on the map Nuketown, in these spots that are shown on screen now. Just play in the hardcore mode and then spam the other side of the map with your rockets. Use the wildcard Danger Close to start with more rockets and also the assault pack as field upgrade so you can refill your ammunition all the time. And again about this one, I made a full in-depth guide in the description below where I'll showcase all the best spots on most of the maps for the long shots. Get 2 kills without dying 20 times in order to complete the classic camo for the launchers and the M79. Very easy to do, just play any hardcore objective game mode while using the wildcard Danger Close and the assault pack, so you can restock your ammunition at all time and you have some more ammunition to get eventually the 2 kills without dying. To complete classic for the knife, you need to execute 25 finishing moves. Also very easy, since you can combine this one with the camo stripes, where you need to get 25 double kills. Once you are behind someone, just hold the button where you normally punch with, and it will do an executing move like you're seeing now. Destroy ground-based score streaks or vehicles in order to complete the geometric camo for the launchers. There are currently only 2 ground-based score streaks, and that are the Sentry Gun and the RCXD. You will most likely never see one of these two, since nobody uses them. That's why I recommend to play Dirty Bomb or Combined Arms, since there are a lot more vehicles there to destroy. To complete geometric for the knife, you will have to get 50 kills while injured. This one can be pretty hard, since you got to be near to death to get a kill while injured. That's why I recommend to play in the hardcore mode while using the perk Flak Jacket, and then just throw down a Molotov to injure yourself. Because you're using the perk Flak Jacket, you won't die instantly. And because you're in the hardcore mode, your health won't generate back. So now if you kill someone, it will count as a kill while injured. Destroy 50 equipment, score streaks or vehicles in order to complete the geometric ammo for the M79. I'm not really going to talk about this one, it just comes eventually and is super easy to do. Just destroy 50 of these and you're good to go. You need to destroy aerial score streaks or vehicles in order to complete the floor camo for the launchers. Aerial score streaks are the UV, counter UV, attack helicopter, HARP, VTOL escort, chopper gunner and a gunship. But all of these are very hard to take out, so only focus on the UV, counter UV and the attack helicopter. You need to destroy 50 of these with the Sigma, and very easy to do since it has a lock-on capability. But on the other hand, the RPG doesn't have a lock-on capability. So what I did is take out as many helicopters as possible possible and make sure to stand near them, because the further away you are, the higher the chances your rocket will pass the helicopter, since it doesn't shoot in a straight line. You may try shoot down UUVs, as I shot down a quite few. Just use the perk Danger Close to start with extra rockets, and the assault pack as fuel to upgrade to resupply like you're seeing back in the video, to eventually take out the UUV. You can also try to play Dirty Bomb and then deploy high in the sky, then fly near the UUV to shoot it down, but this can be pretty hard. Anyway, I'm not gonna lie, this gonna take you some reasonable time, but if you try it these ways, you might get it through it faster than I did. Destroy 3 score streaks or vehicles in a single game 10 times in order to complete the science camo for the launchers and the M79. These stack up, so if you destroy a total of 12 in one game, then this will count as 4. The Sigma has a lock-on capability, so therefore more easy to complete. It can also be simple for the RPG and the M79 if you use the perk Engineer and then hop in a game of Dirty Bomb. Once you deploy in the air, stay in the air until you see a score streak or enemy vehicle, since you will spot it right away through the perk Engineer. Fly over there, take him out, kill yourself if you don't care about your KD of course, because then you will deploy back in the air and you can wait again until you see the next one. I myself had some games where I destroyed an average of 10 of these score streaks or enemy vehicles. Kill 50 enemies that are disorientated by your smoke, flash or stun grenades to complete the science camo for the knife. Best way to do this if you use the smoke grenade and the danger close wildcard, so you have one extra smoke grenade. The smoke stays around for quite a long time, which makes it more easy to hide in it until someone walks by to take him out. Throw all your smoke grenades in high traffic areas and you're good to go. Now we're at the last camo for the launchers, M79 and a knife, and that's the psychedelic camo where you need to get 25 double kills. For the knife I do recommend to play on the map Nuketown, and you will complete this one in just a few games. For the launchers and the M79, you don't necessarily need a double kill, because once you shoot a rocket and you instant reload and then followed by one more rocket, it counts as a double kill. So every time when you kill someone, it doesn't mind where you shoot your next rocket. Just shoot straight after it, because maybe someone just happens to come around the corner and you still get the double kill. Play objective game modes like Domination or Hardpoint in the mode Hardcore, because then you will most likely know where the enemy will be on that objective, and because it's the mode Hardcore, you only need one rocket to kill someone, if they don't use Flak Jacket of course. This was the complete Dark Matter guide for Black Ops Cold War. If there gonna be some changes in the future, I'll make sure to leave it in the comments or in the description below. I will also make a new guide in a few months, what you will see in the description. Make sure to join my Discord, where we have about 200 members that can help you out for the camo challenges or just to game with. I'm also in there to answer all your questions or to help you with certain camo challenges. This video took me quite a few days, so I would really appreciate it if you could leave a like. If this video helped you out, then make sure to subscribe to come back for more guides like these. Also, don't hesitate to ask anything. Leave a comment and I'm always here to help you out. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in my next video.